Another Sydney water main has burst, this time in Carlingford. The faulty pipe flooded homes, caused traffic chaos, and raised more questions about the maintenance of Sydney's ageing water network.
Approaching peak hour on Pennant Hills Road, water gushes from a burst main under a pathway. Southbound traffic was reduced to one lane. Sydney Water took just over an hour to shut it off. By then, Dean Trembath's lower level had flooded. Graham Eyre's apartment was sodden.
Floor's completely soaked. Electricals, I don't know whether or not I can use anything at the moment.
It's the latest in a string of ruptures. On Tuesday, a massive main burst in Paddington. It flooded a car park and left a huge crater in the road. The day before, the Cross City Tunnel was shut down because of a burst pipe. And 3 weeks ago in Carringbar, another main gave way.
This problem has everything to do with Labor ripping out dividends and not investing in the infrastructure in a proper way.
Last year, there were 7,000 breaks and leaks across Sydney. That's 19 every day. But Sydney Water says its leakage rate has improved. 5 years ago, it was around 10%. Now, it's down to 7, which the utility says compares well to other big cities. Sydney Water says it replaces 100 kilometres of ageing mains every year. Today's burst pipe at Carlingford was laid in 1935.
This isn't the first time these residents have been affected by a burst water main. They tell me around 3 months ago, another pipe burst just 50 metres up the path.
Unbelievable, you know, that they burst so close to each other.
Sydney Water will pay compensation.
Just the pipes are too old. The lack of maintenance just means the pipes will blow and people like me end up getting flooded at the end of the day.
Ellie Southwood, 10 News.